see what are the user exit available for a particular transaction code. Okay, so if you go to, suppose this is the transaction code ME23N, okay, and that's for purchase order, and I want to see what are the user exit available for the purchase order. Okay, so in order to go to get it, you go to system, you go to status. So I went to ME23N and I go to programs here, double click on the program, this one, program screen. And now once this opens up, I go to go to, click on go to, I go to attributes and I get the package. So if I get the package here, ME, now what I'm going to do, I'll create a new session, okay, and I go to the transaction/NSE84. Okay, this is very important, SE84. Once I go here and I go to enhancements, okay, and here I select, suppose, customer exits, okay, and I put enhancements here, I put package and I execute. Okay, these are all the exit names that are available for particular transaction code. If I try to find for projects, okay, like the CMODs, and here we don't get anything because this is customer project. What we can do is, now let's go and we'll try to find something, purchase order we did. Now let's go for sales order. Okay, so I go to sales order B03 and I put sales order number, same process, system, status. You double click on this, and now you click, once the program screen comes, you go to click on go to attributes. Okay, and here you can see this is the package name. I'll just enter the package name related to projects. There will not be anything. Enhancements is the place. So here I put the package name, and here you get all this user exit for a particular transaction code. So that's it. This tutorial covers how to find a user exit for a particular transaction code. I just follow the same process. Go to the transaction code, go to system status, go to the program, then click on go to attributes, pick the package name, then come here and you just double click, come here in this transaction, go to enhancement, click on enhancements and give the package name like this we did, and you click execute, and these are all the exit names. If you want, you can double click and you can see this is a function module, function exit that you can use. If you double click on it, it will take you to a probably a Z and Z include, where you can put all your code there and you can show the magic that can be done through user exit. So that's it for this tutorial. Stay tuned to my channel and happy SAP learning.